Namaskar. Good evening to everyone. And myself, Dr. A. Manikandan, working as assistant professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering in Chennai campus, Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham. And from today onwards, we are going to discuss about IoT. So here, actually, first few sessions will be today, and tomorrow half will be theory. And then the remaining will be, we can start with hands-on. You guys have to log into some open source website, and then you are supposed to create an account, and then you can proceed with the hands-on experience. And today, let me start with the IoT introduction. And slowly, myself and my colleagues will take care of the things with IoT, and then how can we interface the things with IoT. That's it. So in these 5 days, we are going to just discuss about this is the outline of the course. So the first, and today and tomorrow, it will be about introduction of IoT and then actuators and sensors. And then how this Raspberry Pi board will support for IoT and Arduino also. So how can we interface things with these two boards? That is about the remaining hands-on sessions will happen in the next few days. So let me start with the introduction. So hope you are aware of IoT, because everyone nowadays, we are using IoT. Without IoT, we can't imagine our days, and then it will be like well associated with our day-by-day life. So just by, I'll give the definition of IoT. So we know what is IoT. IoT is just a system, and that will correlate so many devices. It may be a computing device, or it may be a mechanical, or a digital machine, or it may be a human, or it may be an animal. So all these device things will be connected, and then they will be assigned with a unique identifier. So from these identifiers, the cloud or network will be able to get some information, and then that will be used for future purpose. So that is the structure of IoT. Let me tell you some example. If you are visiting some place, if your GPS is enabled in your mobile, you are visiting some restaurant or temple or any place if you are going to visit. So immediately when the GPS is enabled in your mobile, and you will be getting questions from Google Assistant. What about this place? You know this place. What about the parking? Whether this, and then if it is a restaurant, what about the quality of the restaurant? So all these questions will be listed in your Google Assist. So you will be the device in that case. So data will be collected from you, and then that will be hosted in the cloud. So that will be useful for the next people who are coming to visit this place. That is a simple example of IoT. So IoT is just a structure that will correlate all the devices. It may be a computing or a mechanical or a digital, or even it may be an animal or human. So all these things will be connected, and then that will be, these devices will be allowed to share the information without any human to human or human to computer interaction. We won't need to have a huge server. Even a small device will be able to collect the data, and it will be able to process. So that is IoT. That is the definition of IoT. And the objective of IoT. So objective of IoT is not just limited to connect the things, and also sometimes it will be most of the time, the devices will be able to process the data, and then it will be given to the cloud. So that is the objective of IoT. So that is the introduction about IoT. And let me tell you some a few examples, very simple examples that we are using. First, we go to the structure of IoT, architecture of IoT, some technical details about IoT, then we will proceed like this. So first one, actually have projected here only very limited examples, but we have so many. A simple example is a smart heater. So in egg minder, what will happen actually, when the housewife will keep the eggs in the egg tray, or even the people working in very busy, so they can keep this eggs in egg tray, then you will be getting notification or indication from the smart egg tray, but you have to install the suitable app in your mobile. So whenever you are keeping eggs in this egg minder, then what will happen? So it will indicate which egg has to be used first, because based on the validity, whenever you are keeping some eggs, the date and time will be saved in the egg minder. So it will indicate that which egg has to be used frequent, that is first. So you will get the information, and also at the same time, so how many eggs have been used, and then how many empties, when you are supposed to purchase the egg. So when you have only 2-3 eggs in the egg minder, then you will get the notification in the app. So you are supposed to install the suitable app in your mobile. So even you are busy with your office work or somewhere, you won't need to mind all these things when you are doing things in the home. So that is a suitable example. Simple example we are using is IoT Eggminder. So there will be an indicator so nearer to the tray. So in each and every port there will be a blue color indicator. So this indicator will indicate you which egg has to be used immediately next. So that information you can get in your mobile or you can in the Eggminder also. So that is just a simple example I would like to project. The next example, you all very well know that it's a smart washing machine. And here also you have to use a suitable application in your mobile. You will be able to control your washing machine that you are using in your home. Even though you are traveling somewhere, you can just switch on the washing machine, you can put the clothes there and then you can set the timer and then you can go. Whenever you want to stop, even if you want to start the washing machine, just you can hold the things in the washing machine, even if you just want to start after some time while traveling the car, then it is possible. You can start this washing machine with the smart application, but you are supposed to install that particular application in your mobile. But how these things will happen, how the information will be transferred, how this washing machine at your mobile will be communicated, that is IoT. So that we'll discuss in detail later. So that is the second example I just want to show. And third one, it is AC, air condition. Whenever you want to, before reaching the home, if you want to set your home with a lovely temperature with some 20 or 25, it is possible. You can send a message to the air condition from your mobile. Then before you reaching the home, the home will set the temperature with the whatever temperature, desired temperature that you want. That is possible. So here also that IoT takes place, and again how this air condition will communicate to your mobile with a suitable application, that is IoT. So that is also we'll discuss. And next application, most of the DJ and VJ shows you would have seen that if you want to control the light intensity with the help of an application, that is possible again with the help of IoT. Even in the theater also, most of the place times you can see that in theater, when the movie starts, before the movie starts, all most of the lights will be very bright, and when the movie starts, and slowly the lights will be turned off, and then they will go off. So that is possible with IoT devices with some sensors. That is the next example. So it's called a smart light. We can control the intensity during the time of VJ and DJ show. Another example, if you are sitting in the hall or somewhere else and you want to reduce your burner in the gas stove, it is possible. Again, you are supposed to have that application in your mobile. That sensor has to be mounted in your gas stove. So that is possible. You can, even though you are sitting somewhere in your home, you will be able to control your gas stove. Even if you want to increase or decrease the flame, that is possible with a smart gas stove. And this is also a simple application we are using in the day-by-day life. A smart gas stove. And this one is most of the countries have deployed this one, smart garbage cans. So without the help from the human, these cans can be able to autonomously move, and then they will go to the places and then they will collect the garbage and then they will deposit it there. A common. So again, here also we need some sensors. How these cans can move? We need to have some sensors in which line that cans has to be moved, and then when the door should open. All these things will happen with the help of IoT with the smart sensors and applications. That is very important application nowadays. And again, the next important application is smart farming. You can apply the fertilizer in the right time before the harvesting with the help of these drones. If you want to apply the fertilizer in the right time, you can smell the quality of the sand or whatever the material you have deployed in that for harvesting. So with the help of IoT, you will be able to sense those things. Then you can apply the fertilizer in the right time with the help of the drones. So that is another example of smart farming. And one more thing with smart farming also, that is if you want to guess the climate or for your harvesting. So that is also possible with IoT with the suitable sensors. Nowadays we are getting everything in your Google application with the Google Assist. What about the temperature or whether it will be next 4 coming days, everything you are getting in the Google Assist. But even though you want to have your own sensors in your area, then you can have You can measure the temperature, you can predict everything with a suitable machine learning algorithm, and you can predict how about the temperature and then what will be the rainfall the next coming days. That is, everything is possible with this IoT, even with a smart servers or a portable servers, or we can get everything from cloud like a Google. Another important application, smart health monitoring. So most of you are familiar with the smart watches. So whenever you are wearing this watch, you will be able to identify that whether your human heartbeat is normal or abnormal. Even while you are going for jogging or anywhere, how much distance you are walking, and then everything can be measured with the help of the smart wearable devices nowadays. So the human, even sometimes these watches will be directly connected to the hospitals or your doctors, and the doctors will be able to monitor the health of the patients through the smart devices. So whenever your pulse is abnormal or your heartbeat is abnormal, immediately the message will be sent to your doctor, and then you will be able to contact your doctor immediately. You can get the first aid from your doctor without help of from anyone. So that is another important application of IoT, that is smart health monitoring system. And so many wearables are available nowadays. So those are the few applications that we are using nowadays with our day-to-day life, but not only limited to those applications. We have plenty of IoT devices we are using in our day-to-day life. But how these things are working? Just like that, we are getting information from everything, but it is not easy. How these things are happening, that is IoT. So how this IoT actually happening? So let me tell you step by step. First one is the connected things. In IoT, actually things will be classified into three types. First one, things just, it will collect the information and it will send. It will never process. So that is the first category. Second category, so some devices will receive the information and then it will act on it. That will process. And third category, some devices will do these both. That's it. Let me tell you some example. Whenever you are waiting in the bus stop, then what will happen? Even nowadays, we are getting in Google Map, we are getting the timings of the buses arriving at the particular bus station. That is everything. But it will not be more accurate, but it will be accurate somehow. Whenever you are waiting in the bus stop, you will have some questions from Google Assist. At that time, you are giving only information. That's it. So you are in the second category. First category. So you can send the information. That's it. And sometimes, if you want to receive the information and act on it, you can take some example of this devices we have discussed previously. A small egg minder and then some washing machines, all those things will be in the second category. They will receive the information and also they will act accordingly. And sometimes the things will do both. And that will, these categories will be the server. So whenever you are server, whenever you are going to host the information or you are going to receive the information, so there will be a server with the cloud. That server will do these two. The server will be able to transmit the information and also it will be able to receive the information and it will process and then again it will retransmit. So the server will be able to do both of the things. I will give you a right example for this one. We have our windmills in most of the places you would have seen. This is just one example. We have so many examples. In most of the places we have windmills. And then how these windmills are measuring the energy, and then how they are saving the energy, and how it will be processed to the server, and then there what type of computer we are keeping. So all these things will be done with a windmill. That is in the third category. It's just one example. So how these things will work? So let me come to the architecture of IoT. So any device which can be a part of IoT, as I have mentioned earlier, even a human or an animal, even how you can ask how the animal will be a part of IoT. Even most of the National Geographic channels or Animal Planet, what they will do, they will fix the sensors or cameras with the neck of the eagle or somewhere in the trees, or they will keep the high density cameras or sensors. So they will collect the information from there. So in that case, actually, even trees or animals will be acting as a device. They will be a part of IoT. But how this information will be processed? So that is the next one. We have different type of networks. So first one is BAN, that is body area network. So there is a network that will connect your smart devices with your body. So you have to have a suitable sensor with your body that should be attached with your body. For example, if you want to measure the pulse in your body, you have to have the pulse oximeter or some, you have to have a heartbeat sensor if you want to measure the heartbeat. So that has to be attached with your body through the watch or some wearables. Then what will happen? The devices that measured, the data measured from the devices has to be processed. So that will be given to the watch. The watch will have some processor. It may be any processor. It may be a Qualcomm processor or any processor it may have. So the processor will process the information. Then the communication between these two, the watch and the sensor, that is called as, that will be defined with the help of BAN, body area network. So this communication is very limited to very small distance. So with in terms of some millimeter or centimeter, that's it. And next one is local area networks. Local area networks means within a particular home, if you want to automate your home with the help of IoT devices from your mobile, if you want to control your air condition, fan, and then TV, washing machine, everything, you can see that you can calculate the distance between these two. You may be in the bedroom or you are supposed to control the device or TV that is placed in the hall. So there the distance will be somehow more when compared to the body area network. So in that case, the distance will be somehow more when compared to the BAN. So there will be a separate protocol defined for LAN, that is local area networks. So simple example is smart home. And next one is wide area network. So wide area network is an example will be connected car. So in most of the places, and slowly we are deploying 5G and 6G. So important application of this 5G and 6G is the connected car. So with the help of this connected car, we can prevent the accident. Even two different signal from the two different directions, two cars are coming in too fast. Then these two cars will get the information in the opposite side or from the other side. Someone is coming in this speed, then you will get all the information. So these cars will share the information. So in that case, the distance will be more when compared to BAN and LAN. So that is the example of connected car. There the protocol, how this network will be, the network protocol will be different. That will fall under the category of WAN, that is wide area network. And last one is very wide area network is a smart city. Smart city, even you are sitting somewhere, you are controlling the lamppost posted in the street. All these things can be controlled in the common place. So in that case, please you consider the distance, the whole city you are supposed to cover. So that is very wide area network. Why I am telling all these things? Whenever you have these kind of first one band, LAN, WAN, and then VWAN. So for each and every type of network, you have to define a set of protocol. Protocol is nothing but how any two devices is going to communicate. That is a protocol. Protocol is a set of rules. How your sensor and watch will be communicating. And then how one car and another car will be communicating. How your mobile and then your fan will be communicating. So how can we define the protocols? So that is very important. There the IoT takes place. So based on the device, you can classify the IoT devices in, based on the distance, you can classify your devices into any of these categories, either BAN, LAN, or WAN, or VWAN. That's it. So these are the four types we can brought all the IoT devices into one umbrella. Yeah, this is the architecture of IoT. People may think the protocol in IoT. Normally what will happen, the sensor and identification will be takes place in anywhere, any, for example, you can take the example of egg minder. How many eggs are there, which egg has to be used, what will happen, initial first step of the process will be done by the sensor. You have to find out the suitable sensor. Tomorrow we'll discuss about sensors and actuators. If time permits, today I will start, otherwise we will discuss tomorrow. So you should find out the suitable sensors for your application. So the first step will start from sensor. Sensors will play a vital role in IoT. Sensors may be anything. It may be a GPS sensor, or it may be RFID, or any type of sensor, or IR sensor, whatever may be the sensor you may have. The sensor will be the first step in IoT. The sensors will collect the information. For example, if you are using an egg minder, then what will happen? The sensors placed in the egg minder will send something. Then what will happen? Immediately after sensing something, then it won't stop there. It will give the information to the next level. then what will happen? This information will be passed to your mobile. You have a suitable application in your mobile. So your application will receive the information from the sensor. So then what will happen? That is called as, that will be done by your network. So network construction. So immediately the data received by the sensor will be given to the next level, that is called as network. Network means it may be anything. Even for example, you are sitting in a theater and then you feel like you are, the temperature is too low. You want some, in most of the theaters is available. Even they will be giving the information. If the air condition, the temperature is too low or too high, you can send a message to the people. And you are giving, you are realizing that the temperature in the theater is very, it is not suitable. That is, you feel sweating. Then what will happen immediately? You are sending the message to that particular mobile number. That particular mobile. Then what will happen? You are the device there. So then immediately you are crossing the information to the next level. So if you want to give the information to the theater people, the admin people, then you need to have some network. Some mobile number, they will display some mobile number. Immediately what you will do? You will send SMS to that particular number about the temperature or some whatever the grievance you have. So that is the protocol you're happening there. First, what you will do, once you realize that the temperature is not good, it is not comfortable, then immediately you will send the message to that particular mobile number. So that is the same process. So here also, immediately the sensors, whatever the data collected by the sensor, and that will be given to the network. Whatever the, because it has to be given to the next level. So that next level is network construction. Then what will happen? This network devices will process all those information. So that is information process. So they will process the information and then they will add some security because that should not be hacked by any unknown people. So it will be processed and then it will be given to the end user application. So who is the user at the end? So they will receive the information. So this is the architecture of IoT. So the first step of IoT is actually sensor, then network, then information process, then finally it is the end user application. So this is the architecture of IoT. Yeah, so already I told you that, and we have to have some protocols. Protocol is nothing but the set of rules that can be used to establish the communication between two devices. So we have some specific protocols for this IoT, set of rules for IoT devices. So we will see one by one. So first one is CoAP, Constrained Application Protocol. So it is a protocol. It is a set of rules. So that is used for web transfer protocol for some sensor. You can see the right side example. And wherever you have some sensors in the, even some sensor in the roadside, you can see some solar light. So those lights will be having some sensors. So that sensor will collect the information, then it will be given to the proxy server. From there, it will be given to the main server. So there, the kind of protocol will be used is CoAP. So CoAP is nothing but a constrained application protocol. So this protocol is used with this kind of, whenever you have so many devices in area and all this information has to be collected, then it should be processed by the main server. In that case, you can use this protocol, that is CoAP. That is the first type of protocol. And second one is MQTT. So I will tell you just a best example for this MQTT. Whenever you want to control your AC, air condition, with the help of a SMS. So there actually nowadays it's happening with this MQTT. So this is the most wanted protocol nowadays we are using in most of the places. If you want to control your air condition in the home when you are traveling from somewhere, and if you want to control your air condition, then you can use this protocol, MQTT. So it is extremely lightweight protocol. You can immediately send the information and then you can publish anything through the network. So it is a lightweight protocol. Lightweight means you won't need to have a complicated architecture to process any information. Just you can, with the help of any other service provider, like our whatever the service you are using, either Airtel or BSNL or something, with the help of a service provider, easily you can transmit the information to the destination which you want to send. That is MQTT and XMPP. XMPP is a protocol where we want to use multi-party communication. Google Talk, when you want to have a video calls or even say a WhatsApp call also, you can have example. So there we are using this XMPP. So where we want to have the connected calls or multi-party chat voice calls, so there we can use this XMPP, Extensible Messaging and Presence Protocol. As I mentioned earlier, so you have to identify among these protocols which protocol has to be used for which type of communication. Either whenever you have BAN, which type of protocol you are supposed to use. Whenever you have LAN, which type of protocol you are supposed to use. When it is WAN, which protocol you are supposed to use. Based on the distance, you have to identify the protocol that has to be used over the network. That's it. So for that only I'm discussing. So the last one is very important, internet protocol. So whenever you have a wide area network, I think most of you have heard that IP, internet protocol, each and every device nowadays we have a unique protocol. We have a unique IP address nowadays. So this, all these devices, IP addresses with all these devices will be connected with the protocol, that is internet protocol. So this internet protocol can be used for the wide area networks. So why I have discussed these four protocols? So based on the device, type of network which you are going to use using IoT, so you can select any of this protocol to communicate. You can establish the communication between the devices based on the distance. That's it. Yeah, so how all these things are happening? You may have a question there. Without a computer or something, if whenever you are getting some information, you have in our home, we have some laptop or a desktop. But IoT is nothing but even a small device in a road or somewhere, even in a wild or forest, everything will be the example of an IoT device. You may have the question how these data will be processed and then how it will be given to the network. So that is possible with the help of some devices. They are called as BeagleBone, Raspberry Pi, and also Arduino, and then Intel Galileo. So these are the examples of some devices. They have so many boards, and these are the boards we are using frequently. Even in the forest, whenever they are in, mounting in the high density camera in the trees or in the eagle neck or somewhere, your only the camera alone will not do all the things, and then it will not process. And you have to have some processor, and also the processor should be the low cost, because you can't keep a i7 processor in a trees, because anything may happen there. You may have the natural calamities or you may have the forest fire, anything may happen. So whenever you are mounting some devices in the forest or somewhere, that should be very low cost. Even though it is damaged, immediately it should be replaced by something else. So that is possible only with the help of these boards, BeagleBone or Raspberry Pi or Arduino boards. Whenever you are fixing something, high density cameras you are fixing in the forest or somewhere, so what they will do, they will fix some these kind of a simple processor. This Raspberry, so tomorrow I will discuss about this Raspberry Pi. So these are the smart computers. You can say this, these are the smart computers. These computers will process the information from whatever that received from the high density cameras or the sensors tied in the animals or birds. So they will process the information. These devices will be able to transfer the information to the proxy server or main server. The cost of this Raspberry Pi board is very low when compared to the i7 processor. It is almost around 2,500. This Raspberry Pi is 2,500, but the Arduino board is actually, even you can check with the Amazon, it is around, I think, 350 rupees. So these devices make the things possible. So whenever you are using even unmanned application, if you want to fix some sensors there, so at the same time you want to process the data sensed by the sensor without the high computing facilities, it is possible with the help of these devices. So these devices will be mounted on that particular end destination, then they will collect the information, they will give it to the main server. So all these things will be possible with the help of these. So we will discuss in detail about this Raspberry Pi and Arduino in the next coming classes. So let me just quickly go through the challenges with IoT. First one is scalability. Scalability means, as I mentioned earlier, we have so many devices. Even when you can see the street side, so many devices connected to IoT. So the question is, without disturbing the existing system, how can we improve the efficiency of the particular IoT device? So scalability is an important challenge with IoT, because each and every device needs to receive the information that has to be processed with a suitable server, and then again it has to be sent to the end user application. So that is the biggest challenge with IoT. And second one is interoperability. Interoperability means whenever you have so many devices, you can take the example of connected cars. How these two devices will be communicated, because they may have different types of protocols, and how these two devices will be communicated, and then how they will share the information. So that is interoperability. That is another challenge with IoT. Security and privacy. Whenever you are sending information through the channel, and that may be hacked by someone else. Even some unknown users, maybe it is possible they may receive your information and they will act on it. So that is another challenge with IoT device. Anyone can receive the information transmitted by any sensor. So security, and then next one is design. So in designing IoT devices, you can because they are very compact. Whenever the device is compact, at the same time, the question mark: what about the power? Whether how will manage the battery? Like a mobile, you have to keep on charging the devices. That is another challenge with IoT. And if you have any question from the topics we have discussed, you can ask now. Then I will start the next topic. Okay, the first question actually is relevant to the. I will seek the questions that is relevant to the admission. I will start answering the questions related to my topic. So the first question by Mr. Arvind B. Sir, what is wireless LAN written on my router? So again, it is a wireless local area network. It's a kind of wireless local area network. So you have whenever you have a Wi-Fi connection, if you want to enable the Wi-Fi connection in your home, it is a kind of wireless local area network. Wireless local area network means you will be getting the service from the service provider. Either it may be ACT or Jio, or it may be BSNL or Airtel. So whenever you have the global service provider network, it will come under the category of WLAN. So wireless local area network. So if you then you can get the connection from the service provider, then you have to have some router or modulator and demodulator in your home. So what the device will do, it will be able to process the signal that is coming from the service provider or from the server. So it will be given to your laptop or mobile. Then it will be converted into electrical signal will be converted into electromagnetic waves in your router. Then all your mobiles will be able to connect through Wi-Fi signal. So that is the role of your router. So WLAN is nothing but the wireless local area network. What is the difference between IRC and XMPP? Can you please tell me what is IRC? Next question. Intel 13.5K, but i7 process can you get buy for 13.5K? I don't think so. What is the full form of MQTT? I think message, query, telemetry, transport. So that is the form of, I forgot to include this. MQTT is a message, query, telemetry, transport. Sir, once explain BAN. Body area network is a network that will connect the device sensors. So tomorrow I will explain about the sensor, then you will get the information in detail. So whatever the sensor you are having, how these sensors will be communicated to the smartwatches. Even for example, you are wearing a smartwatch, that watch itself will have some sensors. So how these sensors will get the information, and it will be given to the network. So there is some set of protocols, so that is set of rules, how these two will be communicated. That is body area network. Body area network means the distance, the coverage will be very, very, very low. So within some few centimeters, these devices will be able to communicate between each other. That is body area network. So you can't host it more. What is the second challenge you are speaking? I think second challenge is about interoperability. Interoperability means whenever you have two different devices that has to be connected without the help of any server. A example of a connected car. So whenever you have two connected cars from the two manufacturers, so how it is possible, how these two devices will sync, communicate, and then how they will share the information? That is interoperability. Interoperability means the operation between the devices, they will be working with the two different set of protocols. That is interoperability. How is future in IoT? Without IoT, I think even earlier days also we are using IoT, but without the name of this IoT, we were used to have this with our day-by-day life. And slowly with the name of IoT, we are using them. Now things are slowly changing to EOT, electronics of things. In detail, now the research is going on with the EOT, electronics of things. So you have a great future with IoT. There is no doubt. Sir, what is the future and scope of BTech, CAC and IoT? You have a huge scope, but the scope, it depends on you, how you are going to select the courses you are going to study, especially the elective courses you are going to take in your curriculum in the university you are going to study. That's it. Can you please explain in detail about challenge scalability? So scalability means, for example, let me tell you a simple example. You can take the example of a transport device, or you can take an example of a bus. In a bus, you can accommodate only 57 or 55 passengers. With these 55 passengers, what about the revenue you can generate? At the same time, with some standees also, you can earn something. Without doing anything in the existing system, we can earn something with the same transport. So that is scalability. But when you are adding more passengers in the bus, then what about the utilization of the device? What about the damage that will happen to the bus? So all these things have to be taken care of. That is the scalability. Without making any changes in the existing architecture, how we are going to improve the performance or output or efficiency? That is actually scalability. What is the difference between, is there any difference between IoT and AI? See, actually, IoT, the next step of IoT is actually, I can say, AI. All these things are interrelated. Because you know what is AI. AI means artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence means without the help of human brain, if you can do something, that is artificial. Artificial means that is not true. Virtual, that is artificial. For example, in a restaurant, if you want to deploy the robots to serve for the customers, then what will happen? There, you're definitely IoT also there, AI also there. How IoT takes place there? How the robot first, what will happen? It will receive the customers. It will give the menu card to the customer. From the menu card, they used to order the items. How these items will be transferred to the kitchen? Again, how these robots will get the message from the kitchen? So all this, the transmission of information will be done by IoT. At the same time, how these robots are getting operated. So move left or right, take these things, the internal control, everything will be done by AI, artificial intelligence. So this IoT and AI are interrelated. You can combine these two, that's it. You can't say that they are different something. How is the future IoT? I answered the question, I think so. AI related to IoT, again, I have answered the question. Are XMPP and VoIP are the same? Not like that. VoIP actually voice over internet protocol. VoIP that was introduced, that will be used by the service provider. You can see in most of the time you in your mobile, whenever you're using 4G network, you would have received the VoLTE. That is long-term evolution. So whenever you are getting these things from the service provider, that is actually VoIP. XMPP is the protocol that is defined only by the set of group or set of people they are going to communicate. That is a local, like a local protocol. They are actually different. They are not same. What is WLAN? It is a wireless local area network. Jobs on IoT, even you can create your own job. Not only even any startup companies or any simple businessman, everyone is using IoT. Even you could see that some roadside shop, even some roadside shops are getting order from Zomato nowadays. That is possible with the help of IoT. Is there any best reference book to know further details about the subject. As of now, for IoT, we don't have any specific book, but we have so many lab manuals are available. How can we get the hands-on sessions? In the next class, I will host you the books list of books. Will we learn to code for Arduino and Raspberry Pi? Yes, simple code we use to teach. In Arduino, we can use the Python and also C++. In Raspberry Pi, better we can use Python. Python alone will be more comfortable with Raspberry Pi. Yes, we used to give the hands-on with Arduino and Raspberry Pi, but don't think that we will get the real Raspberry Pi and Arduino. There are some emulators with this Raspberry Pi and Arduino boards. You will be able to connect the emulators. That is, the models for this Raspberry Pi and Arduino boards are available in some website. So we will teach you how can we write a simple code to control a simple LED light with the help of this Arduino and Raspberry Pi, with a simple temperature sensor, how sensors can be controlled with the help of this Raspberry Pi and Arduino. So those things will be taught in the next coming session tomorrow. How the future with IoT, the entire world is moving with the help of IoT only. So you can't neglect IoT if you want to grow in there. Explain BAN and VW. Again, as I mentioned, whenever you are, for example, if you are the distance that matters. If you are talking to someone else who is standing near to you, you won't need to have any device. You can talk to them directly. The distance matters. At the same time, if you want to talk to the person who is standing in the distance of 10 meters, either you have to raise your voice. Otherwise, you have to have an exclusive device between you and the destination to communicate. That's it. At the same time, if you are the person standing in the 100 meter distance, then what you will do? So based on the distance, the way you are going to transfer the information, it is different. So in that way, BAN and WAN. So BAN means within your human body, you are mounting some device in the human body, and then how the device in the body with the same device, how the sensors and watches will communicate, and then how they will share the information. Because the sensor and the processor in the watch, they will be communicating with, because these two will be mounted in the same watch. So the distance between these two is very small. I think distance will be in a small centimeter. So in that case, the type of network you are using is BAN, B-A-N, body area network. At the same time, the patient is sitting somewhere and the doctor is sitting somewhere, and then these two people have to be communicated. There we are using VWAN, that is very wide area network. Another example also I told you, the smart city. So in the smart city, if you want to control the lamppost in the overall the city, and then if you in morning you want to switch off them at 6 o'clock, evening at the same time, if you want to on them, switch on them at 7 o'clock, then it is possible with the help of VWAN. That is very wide area network. Again, the same question. I think IoT and AI difference. I answered the question. We share the PPT. I will give it to the admission team. They will give it to you. Sir, IoT is the last course in the summer school. Can we get the certificate for that? I think that IO admission team will answer for the question. Please type the question slowly to the screen. Is actually moving fast. How is future in IoT? The question again and again, I'm getting the same question. We have a wonderful future with IoT and AI, machine learning, everything. Without these things, the future world is not possible. Anything. Using Arduino, what can we do? Can we do projects like that, and what kind of projects? Even if you want to, for example, a simple example. Tomorrow I will explain you how can, if you want to, the temperature sensor, you can take the example of temperature sensor. You can measure the temperature with the help of temperature sensor. That can be processed. Because whatever the data measured from the temperature sensor is a raw data. You have to manipulate something with the help of some process. The process may be anything. Even you can use the desktop. But instead of using desktop, we can use this Arduino board because it is very low cost, 350 rupees. So This Arduino board can be used to process the information that is retrieved from the sensor. Then it will be given to the next level. You are going to display the temperature, or you are going to act on the temperature based on the temperature on this. Do we have VoIP? In our mobile, we have VoIP. Why do we use Arduino and all? In everywhere, you can't keep the ties on processor to process the information. That is the reason. But this Arduino can do some of the work that can be done by i7 processor. That's it. How are the processor are built? With the help of some ICs that is integrated. You can, I think you would have seen that motherboard, how these chips are connected, and then everything. So with the help of this ICs only, this your motherboards can be, your all the process will be constructed. The same question, how is future in IoT? Moving fast. What are the opportunities after studying specialization in IoT? You can get the relevant job in that. See, everywhere nowadays IoT. You know, earlier you only people are getting job in the MNCs. Only MNCs people were getting job earlier. But nowadays, even you can start your own startup with the help of IoT. You won't need to wait for some MNCs. I can say with the help of MNC, after completing course with IoT or any suitable course in BTech with AI and machine learning or robotics or IoT, you can earn more than anyone. That I can say. Even you can see how the smart guys are earning something. You are getting so many information in the YouTube. You won't need to expect anyone else. You can create your own job if you learn IoT and machine learning and everything. And you won't need to wait for anyone else. You can create your own job and you can create everything. Earlier you want to spend more on things, but after this IoT and AOT came into existence, even you won't need to spend more on things. What, sir, why are you transmitting the information to your Raspberry Pi during the information exchange process? That can be seen by someone else. Definitely it can be seen by someone else. Because Raspberry Pi, I won't say that it is a secured processor. Raspberry Pi can just act as, Raspberry Pi device, I can say that even you guys can purchase a Raspberry Pi from the Amazon. Low cost, 2GB RAM Raspberry Pi you can purchase. You can just remove your CPU and then you can connect to the monitor. But this Raspberry Pi can process the information, it will not add security. If you want to add security, again, you have to apply some algorithm and then you can process. I won't say this Raspberry Pi is just a processor. If you want to add more security, there is another separate part. You have to do some cyber cryptographic algorithm, or you can add something. Then you can transfer from the information from your Raspberry Pi to something. So Raspberry Pi is just a computer. Even in the Raspberry Pi, you can write algorithm for cyber cryptographical cyber security algorithms. You can write there with the help of Python. What is the scope of EZE? I can say there is the scope is more in EZE when compared to the not only in EZE. You can take any branch with engineering, but the thing is how you are going to select the elective or which course you are going to study in detail about in which field you want to specialize yourself. That matter. Even though you are taking mechanical course, how you are going to specialize yourself? That's it. So that depends on you, how you are going to creating the demand for your own talent, then you will get the job. That's it. But the scope is actually very good, so you won't need to worry. Career option with the IoT, again, already I mentioned, it is actually very good. In recent major technology companies have reduce number of employees with the situation. With the situation in mind, will CSC face another slump like this? No, actually, that's what I mentioned. Earlier, people were waiting for MNC. Even nowadays, people also getting jobs in MNC, but people are doing their own startup. That's it. Even with startup, the people are earning in lakhs, that I can say. You won't need to expect anyone, any employees to offer a job for you. If you are completing a course in BTech with suitable specialization, and if you are excel yourself in a particular field, you can earn more than anyone, as I mentioned earlier, even with a small startup by sitting in your home. That's it. But you have to choose the right BTech course with more specialization, that in which you are want to excel. Any computer language is required to do any IoT projects. I would recommend you to learn Python and also C. Can IP address of the device can be changed? IP addresses actually that will be dynamic, that will be assigned by the service provider or server. So it will be changed, but you can't change your IP address. That will be changed by the service provider or server. Can you please teach again what dot before the object you talk about? Before that, I think only introduction. Can IP address? No. What difference between data science and IoT? See, data science is a technology that is used in IoT. The same example again I can say. Whenever you are getting information from the sensors or some places, how these information will be processed, that is data science. So all the things are that is related, correlated, everything. We have joined lately, sir. Please explain. Definitely tomorrow I will explain. Don't worry. Sir, I'm in 12th standard. What should I take in first year CSE? IoT. Let me tell you something. If you want to excel yourself with IoT, you have to choose the course of ECE. If you want to excel yourself in machine learning and artificial intelligence, you have to choose CSE. That's it. Sir, this automated door in the supermarket is also it is due to IoT. Yeah, definitely it is. There is a type of sensor. Whenever the some, yeah, I will explain all those things tomorrow because we have a separate session for actuators and sensor. Whenever you are entering into the supermarket or shopping mall, you will be getting the sensors will be there. Whenever you are entering into that between, whenever you are disturbing the communication between these two sensors, so then what will happen? The door will open. So I will explain that tomorrow. So tomorrow's session will be about actuators and sensor. Is coding required for IoT? Definitely. If you want to change the device, you want to act, then definitely you should know how to code that. But it is very easy. You don't need to bother about the coding. It will be very tough. It is very simple coding, and especially in Python, it is very simple when compared to C. Machine learning is a subject topic, subtopic of AI. I won't say like that. The people will have different perception on this. Machine learning is not the subtopic of AI. What is the difference between data science and IoT? Already answered the question. Sir, wireless cards use LAN, right? Yes. I'm skipping the question. I don't quite understand the main difference between the wireless sensor network and the IoT. The wireless sensor networks actually just they are, let me tell you, they are actually like a satellite connected network. That is wireless sensor network. Your mobile devices are everything is just example of wireless sensor network. But IoT is a devices that will be able to connect only with small distance. They are not connected with a huge wide area network like satellite communication network. That is the difference between wireless sensor networks and IoT network. IoT network is a device. All these devices, each and every device will act as a node of the particular network. That is IoT. But in wireless sensor networks, only the devices that will be able to communicate to the main server, that will be acting as a node. But in IoT, anything can be act as a node of the particular network. That is the difference. What is the application of hub in IoT integrated home in case of power outages? How do IoT devices function? Yeah, this is the important application. I think third day this application will be explained to you by another faculty. So the processing information can be. Processing information can be done only by the objects implementing in IoT. Yes. So tomorrow or day after tomorrow, we will have a small example, simple example. Which programming software will be used in the upcoming years? Now, most of the people are migrating to Python because in Python everything is open source. You don't need to pay anything in Python. All the libraries are available with open source. Thus, IoT plays a role in medical industry. Yes, of course, patient monitoring system, everything, ECG, brain tumor, everything. Whenever if you want to play, analyze something or something, that is, IoT plays a vital role in medical industry. Is there any separate circuit is required to make IoT enabled to present TV? Yes, you need to have a separate device. Or processor like small computers, yes. Sir, will job of data analysis be demand in the top coming years? Definitely, because nowadays, earlier people are people. I can tell you something. People having more money actually used to feel like they are rich, but nowadays I can say those who have more data, they will be the richest person nowadays. If you have more data, you can earn more. That's it. What is the functioning of Raspberry Pi? That is a topic for tomorrow. I will explain. Does IoT cover both software and hardware? Yes, of course. Sir, I have a Raspberry Pi, but I don't know how to set up on MacBook. Could you kindly help suggest few books tomorrow? Yes, sure. But I think it is not a big deal to connect to your MacBook. It is easily you can connect even, but if you are connecting these two devices in the same Wi-Fi, you can, it is possible. Otherwise, if you want to connect them through a HDMI converter, and we have a separate procedure. Sir, the processing information can be done on only the objects who are implementing IoT. Should they be in physical contact? If no, can you explain with an example? The processing information can be done only, no, they won't need to have physical contact. Even with a small Wi-Fi network, you can share the information. Otherwise, if they will be connected to the service, like your mobile device, if they will be connected, you can share the information. No need of the devices has to be connected physically. How can I get more knowledge about IoT and IoT projects in these holidays? It is not something that you can learn within these holidays. I don't think so. You have to spend more on this. Slowly you can learn. Can learning CSE with AI I don't know where I missed the question. Without sensors, there are any means of that IoT? Without sensors, IoT is nothing. IoT is actually developed at the base of sensors. What is the difference between cyber security and IoT? Cyber security is different. Actually, if you want to transfer something in a secured manner, no hacker should have your information. Your information should not be theft. You are receiving messages from your bank and OTPs, everything that will be under the category of cyber security. IoT is different. IoT is connecting devices without any security protocol. That's it. Hope I have answered all the questions. If you have any question, please let me know. Simple example of WAN, wireless area network. Our mobile devices are the example of wireless area networks. That's it. Is HVAC professor means I can't understand this question. Which is better using interface with GPIO in Raspberry Pi or Python better? I mean more function, not user free. I can't understand which is better using base to interface with GPIO. See, by general purpose, I input out pins are actually, if you want to interface something, there are some separate protocols. Either you can use Python or you can even, if that is possible, it's C++ also. You can use C++ to interface with this GPIO pins. So can I say cybersecurity is a part of IoT? Yes. Even in IoT, if you want to establish a secure communication, you can use cybersecurity. IoT data will use cybersecurity. Whenever it is required, it will use. Disadvantages IoT, the security is the important disadvantage. Because anyone can access your information in the IoT because we don't have a huge processor to process the information. Even the simple sensor, small devices will get the information and it will process and it will transfer. So there may be a chance that my data may be hacked or attacked by someone else. That is the main drawback. And battery management system, as I mentioned, you have to make sure that whether you have a suitable battery. Sir, IoT is used extensively everywhere today, but there are so many devices connected, it having different operating system and such. How are the several devices able to send the receive data, though the device is used? That is called as interoperability, I have told you, know. Interoperability is another challenge of IoT, but it is possible. Even though you have two different devices which are using the two different programming languages you have developed, it is possible, but you have to have the suitable compilers and converters to convert the information. That's it. Hacking and cybersecurity, friends, you know, whenever you are going to hack something, definitely there is a cybersecurity will take place to avoid the hacking. Does IoT cover both software and hardware? Yes. Shall we end the session? Yes, we can end. Hope I answered all the questions.